Are my feelings valid? Am I the only one in it? Is it my imagination? Because many people tend to tell you this, you know, that, you know, why don't you just cheer up? It's not so bad, or it'll not be so bad. It'll get better. Don't overthink it. Just do what you have to do. Just focus. But for a person who is experiencing anxiety, it is never so simple. It is never so simple because there is something that doesn't keep them grounded. It doesn't mean that if I can't give you a very clear picture as to why I'm feeling a certain way, it doesn't mean what I'm feeling is not valid. Now, what do we do really with our emotions? We all cope with our emotions. We cope with them, you know, in different ways. We cope with them in healthy manner, and we cope with them in sometimes very unhealthy ways too. So here are some very common unhealthy coping skills that one may have. There is overeating. There is we're known. I mean, it's a matter that people joke about that, you know. I ate my feelings literally. You know, I binged on a whole bar of chocolate, or I binged on some food. So these are common factors where people talk about, you know, how they cope with their feelings. Sleeping is yet another thing. When you're feeling extremely emotionally overloaded, sleeping can seem one way where you sleep it out and you are done with it, and you're, you know, ready for it the next day. But are you really ready? Because what really happened was that you put a lid on those emotions. So here is a list of things that one tends to do. You know, self-harm is one of them. There are people who go and shop. So we talk about shopaholics. We talk about people who tend to lash out, who lash out in anger and take it out on the other person because they are struggling with their emotions. And then we talked about social withdrawal. Withdrawal is yet another symptom. Usage of drugs or alcohol or procrastination is yet another unhealthy coping mechanism. Now, I think healthy coping, what does that look like? Now, healthy coping, if you actually look on the internet, I realize that there are, you know, there are like 100 strategies to deal with anxiety, or 100 things to deal with PTSD, or this or that. There are so many things that are available. What comes to my mind first is the fact that there's so many people who go and actually do a Google search to find these things. What is missing in our lives that one needs to look for something on a platform that is anonymous, so to say, you know? What is needed would probably be a friend. It could be your peer group, it could be a parent, it could be a professional, somebody who one can talk to. And I think it is extremely important that one talks about these things, because it seems like initially when I'd shared this slide about, you know, this is a statistic, all I'm trying to say is that there are people who suffer from physical ailments too. Okay, and we don't talk all the time about statistics. Only when we talk about diabetes or we talk about certain illnesses, we talk about statistics. But there are many, many people who suffer from different physical ailments. When it comes to help for mental health issues, there is a tendency that we hold back. And that says a lot about how mental health is a concern, because this is a point where there may be differing opinions, but this is a point where one needs to consider that it is such an important thing to be able to air your thoughts, to be able to say that, oh, I may not have prepared well, and I may not, or I have prepared well, but I don't know what my future looks like. And that is a real moment of anxiety. How do we tackle anxiety? First thing that comes to my mind is to make it real. What is real and what is unreal? Is there a list that we can write of what is a real fear here? If you go down to a certain anxiety, pick it up and say, what is the real fear here? If you break it down into smaller components, then one tends to realize what is it that one can work with. Then there is something where one talks about walking away and getting a fresh perspective. This doesn't at all refer to that sleeping it off, which we talked about in the previous life. This is referring to taking a fresh perspective. It can be on your own. It can be also with somebody where you are able to get a fresh perspective on the concern that we are talking about. The last one, I'm referring particularly to the last one at this moment, grounding with our five senses. Now, this is one more factor. Grounding, what does this mean? If I'm referring to grounding, I'm referring to collecting myself in this moment of anxiety, to collect myself and talk about what is it that I'm experiencing at this moment. This particularly counts for people who experience panic, a panic attack. I don't know if I'm sure you may have heard of this term called panic attack. And panic attack is this moment of immense anxiety where it feels like something is just about to blow up. All right. And this is extremely difficult. And when it happens often, it is something that is not to be ignored because it is something which one needs to take to a professional. Now, a panic attack could be just before an exam, just before something which is not even as significant as an exam. It could just be a situation where one has been piling up their feelings and then suddenly it comes, literally, blowing up onto your face where you are having to deal with what your concerns are. And that moment of panic feels like there is no tomorrow. That moment of panic feels like you can't breathe, that you cannot deal with whatever is going to happen. Your heart races. That moment of panic is also when one tends to feel that it's all over. And that is a very scary situation. So for somebody who experiences a panic episode, it is very important to ground themselves because the grounding would be with our senses, with our visual sense, with our you note five things that you can see, try and breathe and see what you can smell or what you can touch and experience. So you actually go through the process of bringing your senses to the present. So that is one. In fact, it's a very good exercise to bring yourself in any moment of anxiety to the here and now. I think at the end of the day, one may talk about anxiety, one may talk about panic, one may talk about social anxiety. I think to me, this last slide is somehow more significant than anything else. I had just looked at the poster that Maya had sent me, and it was about axing your anxiety, and it brought a smile to my face. And the idea is to tackle one's anxiety, but the point here is also that one needs to be able to understand where this anxiety is coming from. It is very important to zone in and to figure out what is it that triggers this anxiety. Often enough, in fact, most times, it is coming from a place where one tends to perceive of oneself in a very poor fashion. And unless that changes, it's very difficult to break away from this cycle of anxiety. So when we look at facts factors which contribute to a person's anxiety, you'll often realize that the way they think of themselves, you know, how they feel in connection with others, how they look at themselves, you know, there are many points I think here which one may have not discussed, but they are very significant because when I'm referring to points, I'm referring to how body shaming can be a certain aspect, how people feel about their body, how they feel about their sexuality, how they feel about, you know, how creative or not creative they are, how they believe whether they are important or not. That makes a huge difference to one's perception of self. I remember in my initial conversation also with Maya that, you know, she had talked about how it may not have been an experience for her, this moment of anxiety. And I remembered that, you know, for even for somebody like me, that is not a shared experience. I have, there have been moments when I felt anxious and immensely anxious. So what is it? Where does, what makes us different from the other person? I think at the end of the day, like I said, you know, your perception of yourself is what really frames every move that you make.